Welcome to Black Doctors TV. I am George Price, CEO of Black Doctors USA. Today's program is being sponsored by Aledade, an ACO in the United States of America. We're also joined today by Dr. Michael Satchel, MD, a medical associate of Albany, Georgia, which is also a part of the Aledade Network. Good afternoon, Dr. Satchel.
Good afternoon.
How are you today?
I am doing well, thank you. And how are you?
You know, I can't complain. It's cold where I am, but at least I'm not stricken with any kind of illness. God has allowed me to continue to stay healthy in my family. So I'm very blessed and very thankful.
Amen. Hey, we have to thank God nowadays because there's so much going on. A lot of people have not made it through 2020. So we've got to thank God that we're still here.
Yeah, I mean, and that's the thing, you know, I say a lot of people, and, you know, I know we're not supposed to talk about religion or politics, but I have to say it, you know, based on this pandemic, it has done one or two things. It's brought us together or separated us. And, you know, and that's kind of the work of the superpowers. So we have to either respect that or, you know, we suffer.
Amen. Absolutely.
You know, it's amazing. Out of all the physicians that I've communicated with and now have become friends of mine, I always ask the question, you know, what prompts you to become a medical doctor?
Well, I mean, after getting past all of the things that kids usually want to do, I wanted to be a cowboy. I wanted to be a police officer, you know, depending on what show I was watching at that time. That's what I wanted to do. But by the time I was 8, it really kind of solidified. I wanted to become a physician. Main reason is just my mom. My mom was a nurse for 30 years, and she would come home with the stories about what she did at the hospital, how she took care of patients. And it just occurred to me that was the most important thing in the world, to be able to take care of people like that. And so by the age of eight, I knew that's what I wanted to do.
You know, I have a funny story to tell. Yes, I grew up watching TV also. One of my favorite programs was Bewitched. And her husband, Darren, was a marketing guy. He was an advertising guy. So I told my grandmother, who raised me predominantly, I said, I want to be an advertising marketing person when I grow up. Well, lo and behold, you know, I kind of fulfilled, you know, the dream of what I watched on TV. So thanks to Bewitched, the program from the 70s, I'm in marketing.
It's amazing.
Things like it is. It is. You know, it really is. You know, tell us, why did your practice become part of the Aledade Network?
Well, I mean, we saw the writing on the wall, you know, pretty quickly that, you know, things were moving towards value-based service and that, you know, the government was going to pay us not based on how many patients we saw, but, you know, what kind of value we brought to those patients. And, you know, all of the things that determine the value, you know, how well we're doing with, you know, making sure patients get their mammograms, their colonoscopies, how well we are doing with controlling their blood pressures. All of these things were things that we had to kind of keep an eye on, and we had to do everything simultaneously. It was difficult, you know, the way we were doing it, the way we were doing it as a practice to get all that done. And we had some experience with my organization, American Academy of Family Physicians, who, you know, provided the lectures that we need to maintain our license. And one of the lectures that I went to several years ago was on ACOs, and in particular, Aledade was sponsoring that particular lecture on accountable care organizations and how accountable care organizations kind of helped you to keep track of all of the moving parts that you had to in order to provide that quality care management that you know, that the government is going to be paying us on in the future. And so we got in contact with the Aledade people and find out exactly what they did to provide, what kind of services they provided in order to kind of move us in the direction of becoming an organization that provided that quality care that we need, and how to keep an eye on all the moving parts. And a good example of that is just what happened with this pandemic. We were able to immediately pivot and start going from seeing patients in the office to actually doing patients online and doing patients by video. And, you know, this is not something that we were thinking about, we were even considering, but this is something that a company like Aledade has already had been thinking about for a while on how to deliver quality care. And so already had set up with a vendor to have to enable us to move right in, seamlessly move us in into going from seeing patients in the office to seeing patients virtually, which was critically important, you know, when at the beginning of the pandemic, when we didn't know what was going on and on how, you know, we were gonna be able to continue to see our patients. So this has just been a godsend, you know, an organization like Aledade to help us to get where we need to be and put us in a position where we can respond quickly to what comes, even a pandemic.
You know, what's amazing about your statement, and thank you for that, it's people need to understand the benefits of what organizations have to offer and how they are structured to, you know, work with the African-American physicians across this country. And for me, that was one of the things when Aledade reached out to us, Black Doctors USA, it was they had an initiative to go out and to help the African-American practices across this country that potentially were having some issues based on the pandemic, but even prior to that, just based on some of the things that comes along with trying to manage and run a practice. So, you know, so glad you said that. That's so beneficial to be able to get the information out to individuals that need it the most and to where they can understand exactly what you're saying. So that was very, very, very good. You know, how does the Aledade system provide a benefit to your patients?
The Aledade system provides, again, things that we normally don't take the time to think about. You know, what's the best way to reach out to the patients to remind them, hey, you have to come in for your flu shot, or hey, you've got to get your mammogram done. And so, you know, they have already developed, you know, these mass mailing things, like they have developed a Christmas card that was sending out to all of the patients as to wish them a Merry Christmas, but, you know, kind of remind them for what's going to happen next year. We need to get your annual wellness visits. We need to go ahead and make sure you get your flu shot, you get your pneumonia shots up to date. So, you know, these are things that we know we have to do, but, you know, being a small organization, we may not have the manpower, the time to kind of think about and how to, you know, position for that. But again, Aledade has been there front and center to provide us with these, you know, already made kits that we can send out to patients and use to reach out to our patients. So those are the kind of things that really add value to our practice.
You know, and that's one of the reasons why we partnered with Aledade, based upon, you know, providing that extra added benefit to some of the practices that we have throughout the country. You know, for us, looking at the find a doctor piece, you know, we can actually partner with local practices to help them with their patient flow. And that was one of the things that attracted me to Aledade, because yes, they were focused on helping the practice, but now here comes along Black Doctors USA that now can help that particular practice increase their overall patient base. So it became a good marriage for me and made a lot of sense for our two organizations to collaborate and come together and to, you know, help expand the Black doctors across this country. Because let's face it, you know, when we see people that look like us and talk like us, our healthcare goes up. You know, our quality of life improves. When we go to a doctor that's not necessarily able to understand who we are, you know, we're less motivated to go because we're not getting the care or the understanding of what we're looking for. And that's no disrespect to whatever doctor that you're seeing. It's just when you have a certain culture that can understand who you are, hypertension and various other things, it helps to improve the quality of your overall care. So I can appreciate where you are and what you've experienced. And, you know, for me, I look at Aledade as one of the premier ACOs across this country. So I thank you for being a part of the Aledade network. And I also want to thank you for being an African-American physician, because as I talk to physicians across this country, they tell me the struggles of what they've gone through in medical school, what it took to get in medical school, you know, how you're potentially sitting in a classroom of 450 other students, you know, that don't necessarily look like you. So trust me, I truly understand from the friends now that I've created with doctors, but also the doctors that I have in my network. So my hat goes off to you for your accomplishments, and I thank you so much.
It's my pleasure. And I think, you know, it all goes back to what we're talking about, why I became a physician, you know, and especially as a Black physician. You know, my mom told those stories about what it was like being a nurse and you know, what it represented. Because, I mean, back in the day when she was a nurse, there weren't a lot of Black nurses and not a lot of, you know, at that time. So for her to be able to represent somebody who can step out there and be the nurse and be the caregiver, I mean, that, of course, influenced me, but it influenced so many people that she came in contact with. And so I think that's, you know, one of the things that's important for us is just be aware of, you know, who we're able to influence. And just like you said, those people who don't necessarily trust the medical care system to take care of them, not to take care of their hypertension, not to take care of their diabetes, and especially not to take care of, you know, giving them immunization for this COVID-19. It's got to be up to us to be able to say, it's okay. You know, the system is working and it's going to work for you. It's going to work for us, and be able to provide that, you know, just that not only that support, but that also that, hey, I'm one of you. I'm, you know, I know what you're going through. I know the doubts that you have, but everything's going to be okay. So I think that's important for us as Black physicians to be able to do that.
You're so right. And again, I can't thank you enough for, you know, who you are and how you're helping our communities become healthier. You know, and as I always say, if you're in need of a medical physician, go see a doctor. You know, but if you want to see an African-American doctor or Black and Brown doctor, go to Black Doctors USA, because we have the network for that. But at the end of the day, let's get healthy. Let's help America become healthy. And let's try to stomp out this pandemic that is now just overcome our country at a level to where it doesn't make sense. It really doesn't. And I think if we continue to trust medical professionals that are out there and we listen to them as far as them providing us the information that we need, I know we'll put a curve, we'll put a dent in this thing. And hopefully 2021 will be a better year for all of us here in this country.
Amen. We've got to claim it. Amen.
It's so much. You know, Dr. Satchel, thank you so much today for joining us. Thank you for being a part of the Allidate Network. And just thank you again for taking time out of your day to talk to us about the benefits of Allidate, who you are, and why you became a medical doctor. Thank you so much for joining us today.
It was my pleasure. And thank you for the opportunity to be able to talk to people out there. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.